using PPE because things can get dangerous. Hello friends, I'm back with another fun recipe to try that I've tested myself as your favorite guinea pig. And that is fermented hot sauce, if you didn't already see from the title. Obviously, this wouldn't be a video if I didn't also have a cocktail idea in mind, so a Bloody Mary. I know, controversial drink. I feel like people have very strong opinions about it. I'm obsessed with anything that contains tomatoes, so obviously I really like this drink. The really cool thing about this recipe is that it's really quick. It's very easy, hardly any work involved, and there's so many options. There's so many things you can do to make it suit your tastes, your spice levels, so I'll mention those while we go through the video. This recipe is also really cool because you literally don't need any equipment apart from a good blender if you really want things smooth. So without any further delays, let's get into the video.
I'll write up the exact amounts I used below, but in my hot sauce I added pepper, carrot, red onion, garlic, and the chilies. In terms of fermentation vessels or equipment, you only really need a large or several mason jars and Ziploc bags. I thinly sliced the bell pepper, some carrot, and an onion, and halved some chilies. For the chilies, I ended up using piment d'oiseau. I believe that is a bird's eye chili or bird pepper in English. Let me know if that's not the case. You can cut the chilies in half and leave the stems on for more spice, but to be honest, I wasn't sure my chilies were still very fresh, so I didn't want to risk it since the chilies rot starting from the stem and the top. So I ended up just cutting off the tops, but leaving the rest intact. Make sure you wash your hands properly and don't touch your eyes when you do this. I then distributed everything equally into my large mason jars and set about preparing the brine. Now for this, it's important you use water that is as filtered as possible. I ended up just using bottled water. You will need to calculate the exact amount of salt that you need to put into your brine. I just scaled down based on a recipe that I'll link below, but you can also use brine calculators that indicate how much salt you need to add based on your volume of water. I believe the recommended salt percentage for hot sauce brine is 4%. I dissolved the salt into the water and then I just poured the brine into the two jars once the salt was fully dissolved. Normally, fermentations occur in so-called fermentation crocks, which ensure everything is properly submerged under the solution and stays free of any growth of mold, amongst other things. But we like to do the things the easy way here. An alternative is just to use a weight, such as a water-filled Ziploc bag, to push down all of your ingredients into the brine, and then you want to loosely cover the top just to make sure nothing falls into the brine. You can leave this in a dark, cool place until you see signs of fermentation for as long as you like, although bear in mind that the longer it ferments, the less spicy your hot sauce will be, and you know you will have fermentation activity when your brine has become cloudy, and when you tap or move the jar you see bubbles coming up to the surface. When you're ready to blend your chilies, make sure to strain the mixture but save the brine to use to smoothen out your sauce to reach your desired consistency. I personally left my ingredients in the brine for around 6 days, but depending on the heat level of your chilies and how soon you want to enjoy the hot sauce, I think in hindsight you can definitely leave them for a bit longer. Also, please don't do what I did. Do not use a handheld immersion blender. It will not end well. I left my sauce quite thick and with the seeds, but you could either use a strainer or also just use a better blender. At this stage, you can add some more spices and honey. But I personally just added quite a bit of apple cider vinegar. This will keep fermenting in the fridge, so don't worry if it's super hot at this stage, it'll mellow out with time. It can keep in the fridge for up to a year or so. I'm just keeping mine in the mason jar and some jam jars for now, taking care not to close it really tightly for long periods of time.
So that was it. I hope you liked the video. Let me know if you do make the hot sauce. I'd be really curious to know what kind of twists you add to it. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me and let me know what you want me to do next in the comments below. Have a great rest of your day. I'll also make sure to link the Bloody Mary recipe in the description too, if that's something you guys want to make. Thanks for watching, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you with my next video. I did not mix this properly.